1945 end, another development also took place. 1945 end, another development, which is a remarkable development, which is called INA trial, Indian National Army trial. I do not want to go basics of all these points, because this were covered long time back in some class or so. Indian National Army initially in the year 1942 was founded by Mohan Singh. I hope you all know this basic. Mohan Singh. The Indian National Army actually happens to be created from the prisoners of war who from the Indian side, when they fought against Japan in Myanmar, were caught by the Japanese soldiers. Actually, the Japan took some prisoners of war belonging to the British. British means Indian soldiers only, British army. These prisoners of war were used by the Japanese, and from that one person, his name happens to be Mohan Singh, he started a small group to support the Japanese against the British. Sir, British prisoners of war only, British soldiers. Now they are joining with Japan to defeat British, who is in India. Why? Because British is not needed, both to Japanese as well as to the Indians. Are we understanding? Now, when this INA was created by Mohan Singh, he demanded a strength of close to 20,000 soldiers, which was rejected by Japanese. They wanted to keep this INA, Indian National Army, as just a formal small army, which should aid the Japanese soldiers during the times of war. The INA created by Mohan Singh, according to the Japanese version, should not have greater powers. They should be used for services. Motor thugurthuga, thanvithikidurthuga, samayikidurthuga, idhukalang use panikilang Japan karan nanikiram. Which Mohan Singh rejected. He opposed the mistreatment of Indian soldiers in the hands of the Japanese officers. So Mohan Singh was arrested by the Japanese and placed in prison. So there INA's fate was supposed to end, but it did not. Because what happened? Subhash Chandra Bose, who had been kept under house arrest in 1940, from then he has been kept under house arrest. He escaped from India. He mysteriously went to Russia. From there he went to Germany. From there he went to Singapore. From there he went to Japan. Finally, after meeting the Japanese Prime Minister Tojo, he returned back to Singapore, then reorganized the INA. Japan by this time was facing some crisis, and finally he came to Singapore, reorganized the soldiers who were already left unorganized, and he named this Indian National means Indian National Army as Azad Hind Fauj. Same na ella INA, Azad Hind Fauj, all same Indian National Army. Azad Hind Fauj. Fauj is army, Hind means Hindustan, Azad means freedom or independence. And he wanted to fight against the British. He reorganized this army in 1944. In 1945 he was about to enter into India from the northeastern part of India. That is through this Mizoram, Manipur, Arunachal Pradesh, idirgidala forest, northeast. So he wanted to enter into India from this northeast side. And in this northeast side, when he wanted to enter, he failed. He came as far as Imphal. Then his army was defeated by the British. He failed because of n number of reasons. I do not want to go. They were defeated. But what happened to the leader of the army, Subhash Chandra Bose? Still, we are trying to find out. Whether he is alive or dead, what significance does it mean? What he spoke, what he did has got more significance than whether he is alive or dead today. You understand this? Whether Gandhi died or still is alive, is it a big problem? Gandhi illa adnal enna pannala appa oka nalamudunna ella sende. Gandhi's principle is dead, that is more problem. His satyagraha had been long dead. We are not paying attention to his philosophy, but we are paying attention to the meager things of what Gandhi possessed, Gandhi's chappal, Gandhi's pen, pencil. Satyagraha evaporated long time back. Are we understanding? So in 1945, Azad Hind Fauj was defeated by the British, these soldiers had been brought again prisoners of war. They became prisoners of war to the soldiers of INA, again to the prisoners of war, and they have been kept in the barracks. And in 1945, the British did one of the things which they never should have done. British karne yedi yappo pannanongara konjam kuda or timing sense avanukku irukadhu. 1927, no nationalism was found. Gandhi was tired. The revolutionary terrorists, they have been arrested in the Kapoor robbery case. Most of them have been hanged. No national movement was found in 1927. In the total, British kara Simon Commission appoint pandran India ku. After the arrival of Simon Commission, again the national movement picked up. Now, sir, புரியல உங்களுக்கு சார். 1856, Dalhousie already created so much irritation to the Indians. Now Canning had come. He should have simply kept quiet. Whatever irritation he created was about to explode into a form of revolt. எப்ப உண்மையே பண்ணாம வந்திருந்தாலே போதும். இவர் வந்தவொடனே என்ன சொல்றாரு, ஆல் தி பிரின்சஸ் ஆல் தி ரூலர்ஸ் தேர் டைட்டில்ஸ் ஆர் பீங் அபாலிஷ். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் அவன் டைட்டில் வந்து ஒன்றும் பிரயோஜனம் கிடையாது. அட்லீஸ்ட் ஒன் டைட்டில் ஹி ஹேட், முகல் எம்பரர். He is saying that the future emperors would not be called as emperors, they would be called as prince. General Services Enlistment Act introduced by him in order to curtail the bata or whatever the soldiers enjoyed in the army. So all these ill-timely measures they would have avoided. Greater evils could have been saved, I think, the mystery. Army, understanding? And here in 1945, the British did one act of rascality, which is called INA trials. They said that all the soldiers who fought against the British, no, they have done an act of what? Sedition. Sedition means unda veetukku randam pandrathu. Tamil la solluna, Hindi la solluna, namak haram ke kaam. Hindi konja per oda rendu per irupaan nanikiren, enak theriyadhu. Puriyudha? The British said these people, these soldiers have committed what is called a sedition. So they have been tried. These trials are called Red Fort trials. And Shahnawaz Khan was one person who was tried. Shahnawaz Khan, Prem Kumar Sehgal, Prem Kumar, and Gurdayal Singh Dhillon. These are the three people whose name are caught. Gurdayal Singh Dhillon, Shahnawaz Khan, Prem Kumar or Sehgal, Prem P.K. Sehgal, Prem Kumar Sehgal. These trials are called as Red Fort trials. They have been tried by the British. Indians put up a defense committee, which is called INA Defense Committee, put up by the Indian National Congress. Head of the INA Defense Committee happened to be Tej Bahadur Shapru, Bulabhai Desai. Important two people. Tej Bahadur Shapru, Bulabhai Desai. They put up an INA Defense Committee. Jawaharlal Nehru was also a part of this defense committee. At last, by this defense committee, one thing was argued with the Congress. The Congress said that you are trying these INA soldiers. Okay, we accept. But the point, the British said that they have done an act of sedition. The Congress said whether they have done an act of sedition or not. They might have done an act of sedition, but the British do not have the authority to try these people. Why? The Britishers, in a span of time, are going to quit India. So they don't have the authority to try the Indians. It is a Indian problem. If they have done an act of sedition, we will try them. So the British, you don't try. You have no legal authority. This is the defense put by the INA Defense Committee. The defense committee said the British have no legal authority to try these INA soldiers. But British did not listen. They always want to learn the lessons in a hard way. They tried. What happened is furthermore result of nationalism which emerged. The rationalism turned into radicalism in 1946. 1945 end this is happening. 1946, everywhere it is characterized by strikes, violence happened in India, erupted in India in 1946.